All right, so it's Sunday morning, and the fishing is slow up here. 9 o'clock in the morning. Romo and his dad are fishing. Penn got sprayed by a skunk last night. And now, he's getting a...
90th bath.
He had his peroxide bath, then the tomato bath, and now he's just getting a shampoo bath.
Oh my god.
This is just today.
Yeah.
At least the fishing's not good, so we're not missing anything.
Yeah, it's a skunky kind of weekend. unfortunate life for the dogs. They get sprayed by the skunks. He's not gonna smell any after this. He won't smell like skunk.
Melissa's got stuck in her nose. Like
I know.
Me, Chris, and Romo say he doesn't smell. Melissa's like, oh my god, his nose stinks like skunk.
Easy, easy, easy.
What do you got there, Chris?
It's 32 ounces of iced coffee.
That looks great.
The gas station down the street.
Got us all some of that.
Yeah, well, it's like $5.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, we also have a Keurig. You can just...
There's one. Blind cast finally hooked up. All morning. All morning. Oh, my gosh. Finally hooked up on a blind cast. It's dead out here. I'm just happy to finally hook one. I've seen a grand total of about 。Pulsation right now. He's pulsating like crazy. He was up here in like 10 feet of water. Yeah, this one, I don't know. I was just blind casting an epoxy jig. Finally hooked up. There we go. Whoa. All right. First one is always the hardest. He's not a derby winner, that's for sure. He's a little guy. Still fought like crazy. The old dogfish bar produces once again. Oh. Little false albacore. Yeah, not very big. Not the one we're after, but still good to catch this fish. Oh, took a lot of casts. A lot of casts to catch that fish. There's one. Jigging it and then let it fall. Look at that squid. Oh yeah. Squirting me. There he is. I like that squid. Oh. Oh yeah, look at that thing. Nice. Seem to like hanging out in this area. This dock area. I'm not sure like what good squid habitat it is, like what squid prefer. But I do know that they're in here, so that's all we need to know. Squid on. A little nicer. These things are crazy. The way they change colors so fast. Let's try to get more of these things. Another squid. Pretty nice one. I'll take it. Alright, I just want to get some of that ink off them. Oh my god. Look at that. It was like Jurassic Park. And that freaking lizard sprayed that dude. Just sprayed me. Sprayed me like crazy. Oh, there's one. There's a squid. Oh. Thing likes to squirt, man. Oh. So ridiculous. Squid fishing is ridiculous. Look at that thing, dude. Ew, yeah. Oh, he's gonna almost bit me. They have a beak, like a legit tooth in there that apparently hurts pretty bad. We're snooping around in Martha's Vineyard on the last night. Fishing sucks on the vineyard right now. So we're just gonna try to catch some schoolies. looks real nice. Good looking stuff. I'm gonna throw this skitterwalk. Yeah, this looks pretty good. Yeah, bass just popped right there. Dude, we're gonna catch some bass. At this spot, do we walk left or right? Left. Alright. I did not catch that bass. Catch this bass. Oh! What we got? I'm gonna tell Kenny second cast. This is what it's come to, folks. We're fishing for micro bass. No fish on Martha's Vineyard. Let me take a video for Kenny. Kenny didn't want to come fishing because Kenny didn't think we were going to catch any fish. What do you got there? Oh, it's a keeper. I'm going to send that to Kenny. Yo, this is sick. Sick spot. Oh, Kenny. Kenny, we got a monster. Skiing in monsters. Yeah. Little tiny bass, he says. That sounds about right. Got a wind knot or something. Dang. Fay out. I gotta see what's up with this wind knot. Oh, this wind knot right here. All right, here's the fish. Not a bad striped bass. Taking the skitter wrap. No. Alright, he's good. Got a wind knot. Please, wind knot gods. Let this just come right out. Oh yeah. We're good. Sometimes we're good. Oh yeah. See that? Oh. We in there. I'm catching them. This is definitely worth it, dude. Even if it's just schoolies. Not very big, but they're fun to catch on top water. I never have pliers. God. There he goes.
Yeah, you're good. It's a little bit.
You're good.
See?
Good.
Well, that's the same tape measure I used, and it was just
no,
over.
No, that's plenty good.
Hang him up.
He's 22 and a half. Oh. Easy. Oh, get the tog. Where's the tog? We're rich with fish.
So are we?
How big?
3.9.
3.9? Oh my god. Useless. Useless. Fish on. Folks, fish on. Oh, it's a bluefish. I got this bluefish. I think it's a bluefish. I hope it's a bluefish. Please. Please be a bluefish. Live squid on a jig head. I'm down on the bottom. We're gonna be 3.38 pounds. Oh, that one might do it. That one might do it right there. That one's gonna be close. Close to leader. Leader size kayak bluefish. 3.38. Oh man, that's close. That's very close. Or not make sure, I just wanna see how big he is. Brought this tape measure. Probably gonna bite a hole in my waders. Go ahead. Bluefish. Mr. Blue. Oh no, he's short. He's 21 inches. Alright, we'll throw him back. They need to be 22 inches. That's good. That was like first drop. Last squid right here. This is the final squid. Let's see if he gets bit. Just hooking him through the, what do you call that? Mantle. Yeah, hooking that squid through the mantle. We're trying to find the blues. Let's see. Go down to the bottom. He's not going to last long down there. No, sir. Nothing. Oof. Well, let me get that squid back. Wrong size bluefish. Alright, well, we found some blues. Found the blues. There goes my rod. Got bunkered under the boat. This is a pinfish. It looks like a scup, but it is a pinfish, and we're hooking them. We're gonna drop them down and assume that there are, you know, bigger bluefish down there. Let him swim down to the bottom. Once he finds his way, he's like drifting down ever so slowly. He needs to like get up and go. Get on down. There's a bunker out here. I didn't bring any bunker snags, which is unfortunate. And I don't know, a pod of albies came through very briefly. Had like no time to react to the albies. They were up for about 6 seconds and then they were down. But so far, yeah, we have not been successful in catching any legal sized derby fish here. This pinfish, though, maybe, just maybe, we'll find like a big bluefish. Once he hits bottom, I'm gonna bring him up about 5 feet off the bottom and let him swim around very distressed. Yeah, 5 feet off the bottom. Hopefully that calls in the bluefish. Should, ooh. Right now. I think we are big. This thing is like swimming up right now, unless it's a fish. Oh, there's something on this pinfish right now. Oh, yeah. He's like up top. He's up top. Something's chasing him. Something just chased him to the surface. Pretty sure. Pretty sure he's getting hit right now. Yeah. It's probably bluefish that are too small to really nail them. But yeah, that pinfish literally just got chased to the surface. That's what we like to see. I mean, if this pinfish got bit at all, or has any... Oh yeah, he got bit. Dang. He got bit good. That might be a bigger bluefish too. I mean, that chunk right there, that doesn't look like a little bluefish. Bit the tail off my pinfish. All right, it is the very early morning here on Saturday, October 8th. We bass fished for like 3 hours last night out here. It was futile. Didn't get a bite. Heard a few fish pop, but it was mostly brutal. But I'm getting some crazy marks right now. 5 feet down, we got marks. But yeah, we're trying to catch the false albacore. ridiculous sunrise right now. It's ridiculous. Any minute we're gonna start seeing fish. Second blue runner of the morning. No albies. This fish has to be making his exit soon, otherwise he's gonna die. Oh. It's a southern kind of jack, pretty much. Blue runner. I'm pretty sure these are blue runners. Apparently they're here because we're so close to the Gulf Stream, even though we're up in Massachusetts. Apparently this is a good place to find exotic species because of the Gulf Stream being so close. Oh yeah, there's one. All right. Oh yeah, there we go. This is another albie. Oh yeah. It's running good. I think he's just hooked funny with the SP. Yeah, he's definitely hooked funny. There you go with the SP, always getting him in the weirdest, in the belly. He's not bad. Hooks nice and like always in the belly with the plug. I think it's because they come and they hit it and they miss it and they turn on it. When they turn on it, their belly gets hit. So there he is, number two. Not bad. Sand is real soft. Some real soft sand. Oh man, it's like too easy. I'm trying to get him out of there. But he's 40 inches. Nice 40 incher. Can't even really mess up. He could have redeemed himself. He hasn't caught a fish in days. I was going real fast. And then I let it slow down. And he smacked it. It's a little better. Just a little better. Little bigger for Kenny. One for Kenny. Oh yeah. Damn. Got this popper good. Oh. Is that what you put on? Good idea. Oh, they'll hit that. They're nice and uneducated. Nice and fresh. Oh yeah, a little better. Let's release her. Feyon. Oh yeah. On the blind. We on. He's all right. All right size. Oh. Oh yeah. That was quick. Quick bite. Yeah. Had to throw the epoxy. Oh. There it goes. Come on, man. There we go. Oh, yeah. On this minute, I was starting to lose some faith here. But we got another. Got him on the SP minnow. I feel like late season, the fish, apparently they really turn on to squid late season. And I feel like when they're eating squid, it's a good time to get them on SPs. It's a bigger bait. I don't know. I do like catching them on SPs though. And this one's digging. Damn. He's gotta be hooked funny. He's gotta be hooked funny. The SPs always hook them funny. Cause they wobble so much and these fish are so fast. That's like, they crush it, but they always get hit like in the side. They get hooked in the side and stuff. But I don't know, man, it's pretty good stuff. There he is, he's definitely hooked in the side. Is it a bonito? Is it a bonito? It is a false albacore. Not a bonito. He's not very big either. Not very big at all. That's all right. How slow it's been, man. I'll take two albies. All right. Yeah, he was hooked funny, but I just ripped actually the hook from his belly. We're gonna lip him. And get the hook out. Oh, all right, hook's out. There he is. Probably only 5 pounds or so, but there he goes. All right, good stuff. All right, we've gotten out to the cliffs. We've spotted a whale. There's a whale out here in like 16 feet of water. Up here. There he is, you see him? Was that him? Oh yeah, there it is, man. I think it's right there. I think it's just like pushing a wake, or is that a rock? Or is it a great white? It's waking right there. Or is that a rock? Yeah. Oh yeah, dude. Is it a rock or a whale? It just popped up. There it is. Might be a seal. That might be a rock. Yeah, that's a rock. But there was definitely a whale, wasn't there? Or was that what we were seeing the whole time? Tide's pulling that way. We thought it was a whale. All right, it's pretty dead out here. Romo just caught a nice sea bass. So that's what we're gonna resort to. Fishing for the sea biscuits. Oh. There's one. Feels like a decent sea bass. Pretty nice. All right. It's a healthy sea bass. Pink zoom. Second cast, just blind casting because we don't have our fish finder today. Measure this thing just for the hell of it because they're closed, I'm pretty sure. Up here, he's like 15, just under, yeah, he's like 15 inches. Probably be a keeper. Let's throw him back. What do we got here? What kind of sea bass do we got here? Big sea bass. Not that big. Pretty good. Pretty good sea bass. Might be a little bigger than the last one. Can't keep him right now, which sucks. out of season.